And I don't think it's likely, but there's an attack that's going on right now, and it's Pakistan. Pakistan is another Muslim country with 160 million people, and they have nuclear weapons, and they have the means to deliver them. Now, back last summer in Chicago, there was a debate among the Democratic candidates, and Obama came out and said, I want to have the unilateral U.S. bombing of Northwest Pakistan. Mrs. Clinton said, no, you don't want to do that. McCain said, no. Even Bush said no. And now the U.S. is doing what Obama demanded. The U.S. is bombing Northwest Pakistan. And indeed, the U.S. and NATO troops and the Afghan troops are preparing to invade Pakistan across the Afghan border. Now, why are they doing that? This is the one part of the world where they still talk about bin Laden, Al-Qaeda, the war on terror, all of this idiotic mythology. Why are they doing it? They want to destroy the Pakistani central government. You probably saw the statement the other night from the Prime Minister of Pakistan, Gilani. He says, our national honor and sovereignty does not allow foreign troops to come into our country. And he's absolutely right. But the U.S. and NATO are now going to do that under the new policy. The goal is to destroy Pakistan. You see Iraq now carved into three parts. Pakistan will be into four or five parts. It'll be Sindh, Pashtunistan, Balochistan, Waziristan, and on and on, and that will never end. That's the goal. Now, why are they doing that? Not so much because it's an Islamic country, although that does figure in, mainly because it's a potential ally of China. It's traditionally friendly to China, and under conditions of world crisis, Pakistan would tend to gravitate back towards China. So look at our hit list now. We've got not Iran on the hit list anymore. Iran is now a candidate to be played against Russia. But the hit list is now Sudan and Pakistan. So that's the change. And Obama is the one who demanded the attacks on Pakistan when everybody else said no. So McCain, ironically, was a better friend of the Muslims than Obama was, because McCain said, I talked to General Musharraf about these things. I don't do it unilaterally. And Obama said, no, no, it's got to be unilateral. That's the Brzezinski policy. That's what, of course, Obama has no idea. Obama doesn't even know where Pakistan is. So he's spouting the line that that Brzezinski gave him. Brzezinski's argument to the neocons is to say to the neocons, you're fools, you're bunglers, you're so obsessed with Israel and the Persian Gulf and Iraq and Iran that you've lost the big picture. And the real power in the world, of course, is Russia, China. Those are countries that are seriously capable of resisting the U.S. and the British, and you've got to focus on them. And India, of course, would then become a big asset in that regard. Japan is another one. There's just been a summit of Japan and China. And the big question, of course, there was, would Japan become a staging area for the kinds of destabilizations of China that Brzezinski is planning?